Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Visual Studio on a Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to create a C#.NET project on Visual Studio and how to run that. So everything I'm going to show you on this video itself. So do watch the video till the end, and if you're facing any issues, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there, and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install Visual Studio, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to search over here, Visual Studio download. Hit enter. So that's going to show you this Visual Studio. So just simply click on the first link and it's going to redirect to this page. So one thing I just wanted to mention, that this Visual Studio and Visual Studio code. So if you just simply type Visual Studio code, so these two are different, alright. So Visual Studio code is a text editor, whereas Visual Studio is a IDE. So you can see comprehensive IDE for .NET and C++ developers, right? But Visual Studio is a text editor. So if you want to install Visual Studio code, so that's a separate thing, and I have a video on that as well, so you can watch this video. This video we are going to talk about how to install Visual Studio. Alright, so this is IDE. So here when you are land over to the official site, you will see both community and professional and enterprise are available to download. So we'll download the community one. So just simply click on this free download, and it will show you thank you for downloading Visual Studio. So our installer is directly downloaded. So just simply click on this installer. So that will show you Visual Studio installer. It's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And there you go. So let's minimize our browser. And here just simply click on continue. So it's going to immediately start downloading all the files. So it is directly downloaded. Now installing also began. And it has rightly opened. So here let's maximize it. So you can see that under web and cloud, it has shown some options like ASP.NET web development, Azure, then Node.js development and Python. So depending upon totally your choice, so you need to select all these options. So I'm going to select ASP.NET because I'd like to create a .NET project on C#. So that's why I'm selecting this. Next is whether you'd like to also develop it for desktop and mobile. So here I'm going to select this one. So I want a WPF form or Windows form using C#, Visual Basic and all these different languages. So that's why I'm going to select this, and I'm going to also select this Windows application development. Alright, because I'm going to show you how to create a WinForm project and all that in the coming part of the video. So that's why I'm going to select these two options. Next is all these different options for gaming and other tool sets. So if you are into game development, you need to select all these different options. I'm going to skip it, and for other tool sets, I'm going to select the first one. So often on our application, we need a database where we save all of our data. So that's why we have a special database that is developed by Microsoft, is SQL Server. So that's why we are going to select this. So that's going to help to easily connect with that SQL Server. By the way, if you haven't installed SQL Server, you can watch this video to install SQL Server. Right. So next is all these different options. So if you are into Visual Studio extension development and all, you can always select all different options. All right. So I'm going to select only this and all these different options that I have showed. And you can see that it is telling total space required is about 19.59 GB, so about 20 gigabytes of space it's going to occupy once downloaded, right? So just simply hit install. So immediately you will see it is actually started downloading and then going to install, right? So this will take a really good amount of time. So you can see my internet speed as well, so about 6 MB/s it is downloading all these different packages. So about 5 GB of packages it's going to download, and then it's going to install it, right? So this is really going to take a lot of time. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. So along with Geeky Script, don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. And also, if you're interested into WordPress, so you can also watch all these different videos on our channel, so you can watch this entire playlist. So that's going to really help you to learn more about WordPress. So some videos are 1 hour, 30 minute videos, some are 1 hour video, some are small video, or some videos are in series. So all these videos you can always watch on our channel, right? So here, you know, it's going to take a lot of time, so let's wait for some time over here. So we'll come back, and now you can see that our Visual Studio is rightly installed. So you can see that everything is installed now, so it has launched also. Here it is asking to create an account. So if you have already an account, you can just simply do sign in, or you can create a fresh new account also. For the time being, you can also skip it. So I'll click on skip this for now. And now it is asking to select one theme. So all these different themes it is showing. So starting from dark to blue to extra contrast and light. So it totally depends upon you. I usually code at night, so I'll choose dark. If you want to choose all other different things, that also you can do. I'll choose dark and click on start Visual Studio. And you can see it is rightly launched. So let's close this Visual Studio installer, and here you can click on create a new project. So that will show you this window. Here you can see you have a drop down of all languages. So if you select that, you can see all these different languages. We'll select C#, and under all platforms you can see all these different platforms it is showing. So we'd like to develop it for Windows, so I'm going to select Windows. And finally, it is asking what type of project that you want to create. So all these different options you can see. So we will select a desktop application. So I'll select desktop. All right. So immediately we'll see all these different options it is showing. So you'll just scroll down and we'll see this C# Windows form app. So we are going to select that and we are going to click on next. So here it is asking to provide a form name. So we'll give the form name as Hello World. And all other things I'll keep it default, and I'll click on next. So we are going to use latest version of .NET, which is version 8, so that has a long-term support. You can also switch to standard term support as well. So I have already made a video about .NET version 9, so you can watch that video also. Here in this video I'm going to use the long-term support or LTS version of .NET, which is version 8. So I'm going to select that and click on create. So that's going to start creating our project. So it's going to initialize our IntelliSense. So wait for a minute. And you can see that is also done. So our Hello World project is actually open, and here is our main form, and here is our program.cs. So if you double click on it, you can see here we have a main method, and here we are invoking our form 1. So that is basically this form what we are seeing over here. So you can add a button. So just go to view and click on this toolbox. So that will open toolbox over here. So if we expand this all Windows form, you will see all these different options, right? So from here I'm going to select this button and I'm going to drag it over here. So button is rightly added. And right click and go to properties. So that will show you all these things. So let's change this button to button text to, let's say, Hello World. I'm just giving a demo. All right, so usually you don't give a button name as Hello World, so I'm just giving a demo. So, you know, just write something like this and save this file and click on this run button. So that's going to immediately start building your project. So you can see it is actually started building our project, and it's going to soon launch our project as well. So you can see that our form 1 project is actually launched, right? So this is the application we have created. So it just have a button without any functionality. So you can click it as many times as you want, but it's not going to do anything because we don't have added any functionality. So you can always double click on the button and you can add a functionality over here. All right, So that's how you install Visual Studio and you start working on your C# projects on Visual Studio. Hope my videos are helping you. If my videos are really helping you, don't forget to subscribe our channel and also press that bell button to get notified. And also mention on our comment sections if you need more videos on .NET and WinForms. So I'm going to happily mode videos on that as well. Alright. So that's basically all about this video. Don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax and also watch other WordPress videos. So all these videos are, you know, really informative, and if you're interested in WordPress, so then I can guarantee you that these videos will really, you know, going to help you to learn more new things about WordPress. Alright. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.